Hi everyone, welcome back to another episode of Fit Friday. So today I'm coming at you without a stitch of makeup on because, see, I hate the fact that I even have to bring this up. Like, as a woman, we feel so self-conscious, especially on YouTube, if we do a video not wearing any makeup. I just came back from like a 2-hour walk with my dog. I did a bunch of house chores, and after I film this video, I'm going to start meal prepping for tonight and the next few days, and then I'm off to CrossFit. Just the thought of putting on a full face of makeup just for this video and then taking it all off just seems so ridiculous. Today's video is going to be about food that is by many people deemed as like healthful food, things that you would think, oh, this is really healthy things that I need to eat if I'm trying to improve my diet, but they're actually really not healthy, especially if you're trying to lose weight. Now, some of these things that I'm going to talk about are not actually bad for you in the sense that it's like harmful to your body or something, but there are certain things that you might want to consider before consuming these foods, especially if you're trying to lose weight. Juices and fruit cocktails. So like store-bought fruit juice, you know, orange juice, apple juice, and then there's all these like multivitamin juices, pineapple coconut juice, and they often have these also in a smoothie variety, like banana, mango, whatever, smoothie. You think, oh, this is actually really good for me because it's made of fruit. There's lots of vitamins in here. They contain a lot of sugar in a really concentrated form. One glass of orange juice or something, that could be several hundred calories each time you drink a glass. So if you're not drinking water a lot and you're just using, you know, juice from concentrate, even sometimes the fresh squeezed juices that you can purchase at like grocery stores and stuff, they contain a lot of sugar. Very processed. It's not the same as if you have a juicer at home and you're making your own juice. So they're kind of very processed drinks. The fact that it's in this liquid form means you're often consuming way more of it than you should. You know, instead of having a fruit juice, is to just drink water and have a piece of fruit. So if you are craving something fresh, have a glass of water and then have like one orange, because that will fill you up more. The orange is going to be giving you tons of vitamins, and you're actually going to be consuming less sugar. You're probably not going to be consuming as many fruit in the like whole variety as you would if you were drinking it in a liquid format. If you really, really love juice, is to invest in a juicer and juice it yourself using fresh ingredients, and then always mix your juice with vegetables. So if you want to have like an orange juice, why not have an orange carrot juice or an orange carrot celery ginger juice, something like that, so that you're not just consuming oranges. If you really can't give up fruit juices, like especially the concentrated kind, the ready-made kind, is to thin them out with water. So if you're making a glass of orange juice, put like, you know, take your glass, put maybe a third of the concentrated orange juice on the bottom and then fill it up with water. The classic breakfast cereals. You know, there's like the obvious ones. They're like Corn Pops and like Honey Nut Crunch and Cheerios, like the sweet ones and stuff. You think, okay, well, obviously I would avoid those, but even sort of the healthy breakfast cereal, like Special K and Weetabix, and I don't even know what they're all called. These things sometimes have hidden sugars in them, so they're not maybe obvious that sugar has been added to the cereal, but then when you look at the ingredients list, they have added sugar in some form. These are just really, really processed foods. You know, Corn Flakes and Special K and all these, like this does not exist in nature like that. So if you're someone who really enjoys having cereal in the morning, is I would just advise to buy the whole grain cereal. So that's why I sometimes eat muesli in the morning, because it's made with whole oats. You can buy whole oats, you can buy whole millet and whole nuts or whatever, and make your own combination, really using the whole grains that are completely unprocessed. You know, you can add some fresh berries, maybe some fresh blueberries, fresh raspberries or something, and then just have that with milk. Don't add any sugar to it. Like a really nutrient dense breakfast that is not processed and that doesn't have any contained sugars. And in a similar vein, these are granola bars. Oh my God, granola bars are basically just candy. They're often sold kind of in the health food aisle and like the breakfast aisle. So you kind of think that you're buying something that's really good for you. If you actually look at what's in most granola bars, there are so many added ingredients there that first of all make them very processed. So there'll be like lots of sugars in there. You know, sometimes they'll add corn syrup and they'll add something to make that sticky texture so that they can press it into a granola bar. Sometimes they'll be coated with chocolate. Sometimes they'll have dried fruit in there. These things are so, so calorie dense. You know, they're usually very small. There isn't a lot of volume to them. So even if you eat a granola bar, your stomach is not gonna feel full. You're probably not gonna feel completely satisfied and full after that, but you're getting so many calories in just that one granola bar. Very processed, so, so, so much sugar. Often there's a lot of fat in them as well, like added fat, trans fats, things like that. Dried fruit. So dried fruit is something that often people go to. They're like, oh, okay, I'm gonna stop eating candy and I'm going to have some dried fruit instead. It can be absolutely incredible how many calories and how much sugar you're consuming because the fruit has been dried. The sugars actually become more concentrated. So if you were to eat like one fresh whole apple, you would be probably consuming a lot less sugar than if you're eating a handful or like a whole serving of dried apple slices. Often also in dried fruit, they've added a bunch of preservatives to dried fruit so that they don't lose their color and that they still like look appealing. So you're getting all these added preservatives to dried fruit, dried figs, dried dates, dried mango slices, all super, super yummy, but you should treat this like candy. So if you are thinking that you're doing something really good by eating dried figs, just look at how much sugar is in there and consider it as candy. So if you really can't give up dried fruit and that's something you really love snacking on, then make sure you really portion out an appropriate serving size because I tell you, it's not a whole lot. It might be like three figs might be the allotted serving size and just calculate how many calories that is. So my alternative is just to eat the piece of fruit fresh and look at which kind of fruit contains less sugar. So I always go for berries. If I want a sugar fix, I get some strawberries. Some raspberries are really great. Blueberries are a little bit higher, but they're also really great. Trail mix. So this is something that a lot of people switch over because they want to snack. And so they think, oh, I'm gonna get like something more healthier, which is like it's mix of nuts, usually like peanuts and almonds and walnuts or whatever mixed with raisins and other dried fruit. So we've already covered dried fruit and nuts are healthy for you. There's a lot of good nutrients in nuts, but they're extremely high in calories. So you wanna be really, really careful about your serving size when you're eating trail mix, especially if you're at home, you know, sitting in front of the TV and you think, oh, I want a snack, I'm gonna grab some trail mix. Well, be super careful because it is an extremely calorie dense snack. That's why it's called trail mix, is that you're supposed to eat that when you're on the trail hiking or mountaineering or something. And this is when I eat trail mix, is I like to go hiking and when I know I'm doing a super strenuous hike, that's usually all the food I'll take with me is trail mix because it is so incredibly calorie dense. You know, a bag of trail mix like this and that'll be absolutely plenty of calories for me to last throughout the whole day doing a really strenuous activity of hiking. And it really does give me that instant energy, especially if I'm going uphill for hours and hours. I don't eat trail mix at home sitting around because you guys, there are so many calories in here. Just try not to snack. If you really like snacking, snack on vegetables. You can always snack on vegetables. You know, snack on celery sticks, snack on cherry tomatoes, carrot sticks, whatever. Store-bought fruit yogurts. Another thing that a lot of people think, oh, it's healthy. You know, yogurt is good for me. It has a lot of calcium in it and fruit is really good for me. It has vitamins in it. These ready-made fruit yogurts that you can buy at the grocery store have so much added sugar in them and also often a lot of preservatives and stuff that they're really just not very good for you. You should consider that as a dessert. The alternative, what I do is if I want some fruit yogurt, I just buy the plain unsweetened yogurt. You know, you can buy Greek yogurt, whatever you like, add some fresh berries to it. You can even buy frozen berries, mix those up, and then either use a sugar replacement or just don't go for any sugar at all. I like my yogurt sweet, so I like to use stevia, and that way you'll have a healthy snack. You'll have that fruit yogurt taste, but you're not adding all the sugar. So sometimes one little container of fruit yogurt has basically as much sugar in it as you should be eating for the entire day. So just keep that in mind. So another thing that a lot of people do is when they want to avoid sugar, they'll go to different kinds of sugar replacements. Often they'll pick like the wrong replacement. Now that I've reduced my sugar intake, I don't get these sugar cravings anymore. But sometimes, you know, I like to maybe sweeten my tea a little bit or something. So I use stevia. But some people, what they'll do is instead of using stevia or something like that, they will use other types of sugars, which really are not really much better for you than plain like white crystallized sugar. Honey or agave syrup or date syrup, coconut sugar, maple syrup is another really popular one. Alternatives to sugar, but they're really no less calorie dense than sugar. If it's sucrose or fructose or glucose or whatever, sugar is sugar. You know, your body might use it a little bit differently according to what kind of source you're using, but at the end of the day, they're all calories that you're adding to your meals. So if you're trying to reduce sugar, don't just switch over to using honey or just to using maple syrup or agave, because you're not really reducing the amount of sugar that you're intaking. You're just using a different kind. What I do is I've just started to reduce the amount of sugary things that I'm eating. Try to get over that first initial addiction that you have to sugar, because I definitely had one. You know, I was always craving something sweet. If you do want to use a sugar replacement, I personally really love stevia. There's zero calories in stevia. So you want to start to be mindful of the types of fruit that you're consuming. So this is kind of like a double-edged sword, because on the one hand, you know, fruit does have a lot of vitamins in them. They have a lot of nutrients that are in fruit that you can, you know, it's a whole food. So a whole food is always better for you than a processed, you know, food like a Snickers bar. So, you know, it's always better to eat a banana rather than a Mars bar. That's for sure. But if you are trying to watch your caloric intake and your sugar intake, you want to be mindful of what types of fruit you're eating. So like I said, I love eating berries. They give me that fruit kick. They have a ton of nutrients and antioxidants in them, but they are very actually low in sugar content when compared to other fruits. So things like oranges, bananas, oh my God, you guys, bananas are so delicious. I used to put bananas, like a lot of bananas, in my smoothies and stuff because they're just so filling. They have that creamy texture. Yeah, bananas, also mangoes are extremely high in sugar content, and grapes are also really high in sugar content. Grapes are sometimes made into grape juice concentrate, and grape juice concentrate is often used sneakily in products to sweeten them. So it's basically another form of sugar. That's something that you might want to consider, is what type of fruit you're eating. There's nothing wrong with eating a banana or something. I'm not saying like bananas are bad for you or whatever. They're absolutely not. But if you are someone who's trying to reduce your weight and you're looking at calories and you're looking at sugar intake, then just pick a different type of fruit. All right, so that is it. I hope this video has been super helpful for you. Thank you guys so much for watching another Fit Friday. Check back on the playlist if you're interested in more videos like this, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.